it's Raven. I'm super excited for this video because I am finally bringing you guys my empty house tour. If you guys have been following me for a while, you know that I have been building this house for the past year and it is finally done. It is still empty because I have not moved in yet. I'm actually moving in tomorrow, but I wanted to show you guys what the house looks like before I get all my stuff in here. So this is my front door. I love it. I know it's kind of a silly thing to be excited about, but I just think it's so beautiful with the glass and the black iron. Super excited about the way that kind of the whole front of my house came out. I just think it's so aesthetically pleasing. I love the white stucco with the black details. It's very my style, very neutral, very minimal. So yeah, come on in.
So obviously this is what my front door looks like from the other side. So we're standing in my entryway. So this is one of my favorite spaces of the house, just in terms of how aesthetically pleasing it is. I love my entryway because the stairs just make such a focal point. I just like the way that the stairs, the front door, and the light fixture all play off of each other and add some contrast against all these white walls. If you guys saw my other vlog, you know all the hoopla that happened with that light fixture, but we finally got it right and I really like the way that it turned out. So I'm gonna take you guys through the entryway in a minute, but first I wanna show you guys kind of what's in the front of the house. So over here on the left side, we have these French doors that actually lead to my office. I went for a very simple French door, just clear glass, no extra framing or anything. I really wanted a modern farmhouse type of look throughout my house, but everything with very clean lines, very simple, very modern, contemporary at the same time. So let's look inside my office. So obviously right now it is just a big empty echoey room. I have plans to put a nice light fixture up. I have some tape on the floor that is kind of designating my plans for having like a cute couch in here with my desk and some bookshelves. So my computer would be over here. And then we'll have like a nice little sitting area over here. And I have my big window, which I think is super awesome for an office because sometimes when I'm editing, I kind of feel kind of trapped. And I like having the big window to bring in a lot of natural light. I think it'll just kind of pep me up a little bit when I'm editing so I don't feel so trapped in. I can also just lift the blinds all the way up and just have like full natural light. So I honestly won't even need to turn the light on during the day. It's so bright. So then going this way from the office, we have the powder bathroom. This bathroom is basically just the powder bathroom. Obviously, this is what guests will be using when they come over. So I decided to do a little bit of a fancier tile in here just to do something different. I still have to kind of decorate it and kind of zhuzh it up a little bit just because I wanted to be a little nicer for guests. But so far, I really do love the tile that I chose. I think it's a nice pop of pattern. And then through here is my glam room. So this is what I'm calling my glam room. This is basically going to be my makeup studio, wig studio, filming studio, just my glam room. So I plan on having a lot of makeup storage in here, wig storage. It has these big, beautiful windows, which are not only decorative, but also help to bring in a lot of natural light, which is perfect for filming YouTube videos, Instagram content, little photo shoots, whatever I want to do. It's a nice large bedroom. It would normally be used for like a guest room or something like that, but I already have a guest room designated upstairs, so this is just perfect for my little filming room. I cannot wait to start shooting content in here. It's giving me lots of space so I can do like outfit fashion content, photos, videos, whatever. And it has its own full bathroom and closet. So when I am shooting content in here or doing my makeup or I need to come and wet my beauty blender or whatever, I have my full bathroom in here with the sink, with some storage, toilet, full shower. There's a whole like toiletry or like, what do you call it? Linen closet in here that I can store stuff in. And there is a full walk-in closet, which I do plan on using to store equipment, backdrops, extra clothing, shoes, wigs, whatever else I might want to have in here readily accessible to use for filming. So in this bathroom, I went for a little bit of a sparkly glam neutral vibe because it is the glam room. I wanted to add a little bit of sparkle. So the countertops are this really nice gray, but if you look closely, it has like a glittery effect. And And the shower just has gray tile with the flooring to kind of match everything. I still wanted to keep it neutral because eventually I might turn this room back into a bedroom or a guest room. So I didn't want to do anything like crazy pink, whatever, but just a little bit of sparkle. So that's the office, powder room, glam room, staircase, and then through here is the laundry room. One thing I really love about this laundry room is that it has a sink with all this counter space and cabinet storage underneath. I've never had a laundry room anything like this before. This sink I feel is really gonna come in handy because when you have a toddler, sometimes you have some nasty messes that you need to rinse real quick before you put it in the washer. And I just think it's super handy to have a sink in here. So I'm super excited about that. I went for a neutral vibe again with the countertops and the cabinets. So the countertops are kind of this off-white color with a little bit of like glass speckle. And then the cabinets are this really pretty light gray. So the countertop kind of is this L shape all the way here. So I have tons of storage all throughout here to hold all of my laundry, cleaning supplies. Everything can be nicely tucked away so it doesn't look cluttered in here. And then over here in this space that is just empty, I have a special hookup that is for a refrigerator. I plan on getting a drink fridge. So kind of like those glass front fridges that you see in the gas station where you get your drinks from. I want to have one here that is just like stocked up with sweet tea, kombucha, water bottles, so that when guests come in, they can grab a beverage, or when I'm on my way out the garage, which is right there, I can grab a drink when I'm coming and going out. And of course, this is a laundry room, so you have to have a washer and dryer. So these are brand new. They were just installed. But I just really like this laundry room because I feel like it actually kind of makes you want to do laundry. It makes you want to keep everything nice and clean. It gives you space to fold clothes over here on the countertop. Like, I can actually see myself enjoying doing the laundry in this laundry room. So around the corner from the laundry room is what I'm calling the assistant's office. So basically this is just like an extra little room that kind of has this built-in desk countertop area, and I'm gonna be using it for an assistant's office, especially my sister this summer. So she can have this office. I'm gonna put a computer in here. Right now I just have this old chair from like my old apartment, but I'm gonna get a nice pretty chair and like maybe put some shelving up on the wall and have some organizational stuff in here. So it's a nice little closed off room that my sister or my mom can come and work in. And I also plan on using it for like a mail sorting room slash giveaway room, because you guys know I get a lot of PR packages and I do a lot of giveaway boxes. So this will be a good area to kind of facilitate all of that. One thing that I really like about this entryway area is the archway behind me. I just think it adds a really pretty architectural touch. And that leads into the living room. So this is my living room. One thing that I really love about this living room is the super tall two-story ceilings, and it just feels so big and open and airy in here. It just makes me happy. I love that open, airy, bright feeling. So all of the windows with the tall ceilings and the white walls, it just, I love it. And one of the main like focal points in here is the big tiled wall over here where my fireplace is. And I just got my brand new TV mounted on the wall. So I went for a dark charcoal colored tile just to pop against the white. And like I said, just kind of add like a focal point over here. And I also think it looks nice because the TV and the fireplace kind of blends in. So it just gives you like a really clean look. And I also really like the fact that since the tile goes all the way up to the ceiling over here, it really draws your eye up so you can really appreciate the tall ceilings. And actually, this is not a fully empty house tour because my sofa came in earlier than expected. I just got this in like yesterday. I got this from Z Gallery. It's like an L-shaped sectional. It's just like a beige color to kind of play off the tones of the floor. And it's super big and comfy. And right behind the couch, I have my big sliding door, which leads out into the patio. And this whole wall right here is basically just like one giant window. So it brings in so much natural light. It looks so beautiful when the sun is up, and it even looks beautiful at night too. It just creates like such a cool vibe. Through there is my master bedroom, which I'm gonna show you guys in just a second. But first, let's go over here to the kitchen. This is my kitchen. I went for an all white theme pretty much with my kitchen. So I have these quartz countertops that look like marble. It's actually not marble, it's just kind of got like a marble print to it, but it's actually quartz, which is actually a little bit more sturdy and easier to maintain. The main thing I really love about this kitchen is all of the bright white cabinetry with the white countertop and the white walls. I mean, I've always wanted an all-white kitchen with just little pops of black and brass, and I just had my black cabinet pulls added on there for just like a pop of contrast. We have the microwave and oven area, which I didn't even know, but this oven that came with the house has Wi-Fi capability. You can like connect your phone to it so that if you're on your way home and you want to preheat the oven for dinner, you can preheat the oven from your phone. Nothing too fancy about my fridge. I was thinking about getting one of those ones that has like the screen on the outside and the window and all like the fancy stuff, but I actually just like the clean look of this one a lot better. There is so much storage in here. All the cabinets go all the way up to the ceiling. And as you can see, I have these cabinets on top that have the glass windows with the lighting inside. And I plan on putting a lot of decorative pieces up there, like different little plants and statues and stuff like that, just to make that like really interesting up there. I also really love the way that my vent hood looks. I feel like it just makes my kitchen look a little bit more gourmet, professional. Like, I really know how to cook because I got one of these and I got a real gas stove. This is my first time having a real gas stove. I don't even know how many cabinets there are, but there's a lot. I will never run out of storage space in this kitchen. So for the backsplash, I went for a herringbone pattern with an artisan subway tile. So it's got a little bit of a detail, like rough around the edges, and it's in the herringbone, kind of that zigzag shape, just to add a little bit of texture to the backsplash. I didn't really want to add any color, but I did want to add some extra texture. And another little special thing that I really like is the under cabinet lighting, which just illuminates this countertop really nicely. Then of course we have the kitchen sink, nice big kitchen sink over here, and my dishwasher is right here. And then through here is the pantry. So this is my pantry that is unnecessarily large. Even I can admit that, but it just came with the floor plan of the house. I did not specifically choose to have a pantry this big. I don't know what people do with a pantry this big. The shelving goes all the way around. I mean, literally my food is only gonna take up like this much space. So I don't know what else I'm gonna use it for. This house just has so much storage. Like I said, I'm never gonna run out of storage space. So then over here is the actual dining area. I don't have a formal dining room in this house. I just didn't feel the need to have one. So this is the dining area. And once again, I do actually have some furniture in here. This table is from Z Gallery and it was delivered on the same day as the sofa. So I absolutely love this dining table. I think it goes really, really nicely with the flooring. And I just love the way that this whole area is already starting to come together. Light fixtures make such a big difference, and once you start getting your big furniture pieces in, the house starts feeling like it's coming together. So I can already imagine how it's gonna look with the chairs. I plan on putting like some big artwork over here, you know, some plants, a nice little tablescape. But the cool thing about this table is that it does expand even longer. So for holidays, you know, Christmas, Thanksgiving, I can actually extend this table and seat even more people, so it will be able to hold my entire family. And then over here, I actually have a door that leads straight out to the patio. So if I am having a barbecue or something like that, people can kind of go in and out from the patio. I plan on having an outdoor kitchen out there. I'm gonna show you guys in a minute, but it's just this really easy access straight from the kitchen to the patio when you're cooking, grilling, having a party. I just think that this is like the perfect little flow. So why don't we go take a look at the patio? I absolutely love this patio. It is so big and spacious, and the whole thing is covered with a huge fan up here, so it's nice and shady. We can turn the fan on if it gets really hot out here. And I just had this TV mounted out here, and these hookups right here are actually for my future outdoor kitchen. So I plan on having a grill with countertop space, a little mini fridge, a sink, just the whole little like setup through here. And then I'm gonna get some nice patio furniture, maybe like a coffee table with a couch, maybe a couple chairs. I'm not exactly sure yet, but I have a lot of space to work with. And of course, over here we have the big sliding door, which actually slides all the way open. So again, if I'm entertaining, this will be really nice to just have this open so people can go in and out. It feels like indoor, outdoor living is what they call it. So everything is kind of just one space. I've also got this speaker system out here, which is connected to my phone, so I can play Apple Music, Spotify, whatever. So we have the music pumping, the grill going, the TV on, the seating area out here, the seating area in here. You can go in and out. You can go to the kitchen, get you a drink. You feel the vibes. I just absolutely love this patio. Again, I think it's just one of the main features of the home that just caused me to fall in love with this overall floor plan. I can just really see myself actually entertaining out here, spending time with Zaya out here. She has plenty of grass space right down these stairs to where she can go and play. So past the living room is my master bedroom. It kind of has this little tucked away corner so you can't like see my door like right from the living room. So right away, one of the first things that you notice about my master bedroom is the super tall ceilings. You can kind of see the shape of the roof, and it's just, I don't even know how tall these ceilings are, but they're super tall. They're like two-story ceilings, which just opens up the room and makes it feel very open and airy. Plus you have this beautiful array of windows over here, which really helps to bring in that natural light, like I keep saying, and it just really adds so much to the room. I will have my king size bed here with some nightstands on either side, some big plants on either side. I plan on having mirrors on the wall. And then through here is my master bathroom.
Wait, pause the video. I'm actually not gonna be showing you guys my master bathroom or my master closet in this video. I am going to be doing a separate video a little bit later all about my bathroom and my closet. I'm still working on it, so I want it to be perfect before I show you guys. So just stay tuned on my channel for that.
Okay, so now from the living room going back through the archway, we're gonna go up the stairs. Again, I just really love these stairs. I love how the dark and the light play off of each other. That's kind of the theme throughout my whole house, is like the contrast between like black and white or really dark stain. This is actually not black. It's like a really, really, really deep chocolate brown. I made them go over this stain like 5 times to make it as dark as possible. And I also just really love the shape of the staircase. I think it's super elegant. I went for a very simple railing, you know, nothing too crazy. I just wanted the stairs to kind of speak for themselves, you know? So when you walk up the stairs, you first kind of see this catwalk balcony area. This balcony looks over the living room. So the whole house is very open concept. So you kind of feel like you can hear and see everything, which I think is perfect for me and Zaya. You know, it's not super closed off. The first room that you walk into is the playroom. This is where all of Zaya's toys will live, and kind of like her little homeschool setup. Just all of her stuff can be nicely corralled and organized into this one space. In my townhome, everything was kind of like in the middle of the living room, in the kitchen. It got really messy really fast. So now she has this whole room that she can spread out, she can play, she can do whatever she wants, and she can have, you know, plenty of storage. I'm gonna put some cubbies, I'm gonna put a couch, a table, you know, plenty of space for her to do arts and crafts, play with all her toys, have all her doll houses, stuff like that. Again, we've got three big windows in here to bring in tons of natural light, and just had this TV mounted so Zaya can watch Peppa Pig in her playroom. Another cool little extra feature that I had added in here is this Nest indoor security camera, which is hooked up to my phone, so that if Zaya is ever in here and I need to run downstairs but I still want to keep an eye on her, I can actually watch her on live video from my phone. This camera has a fisheye lens that can see the entire room. And then through here, this is just another extra little secret room. My builders had told me at first that it was just gonna basically be more like a storage attic unfinished space, so it wasn't gonna have like finished walls or finished flooring, but it does. So I don't know if they accidentally gave me that, but it's got carpet, it's got walls, it just doesn't have any windows, so you can't technically make it into like a room. But it's actually a pretty spacious little storage room, and I don't currently have plans for this room. I mean, there's so much storage throughout the rest of the house. I really don't need yet another room to store stuff in just yet. But that is the good thing about this house, is that it is giving me room to grow. And if anything changes in my life, if I need that room to grow, if I don't know, you never know what might happen and what I might end up using this room for. So this is just like an extra little secret hideout for now. And then right off the playroom is Zaya's room. So this is Zaya's bedroom, but first you see her bathroom, which is right here. The way that this floor plan actually came was with a Jack and Jill bathroom that the guest room over there would actually share with Zaya. But I wanted Zaya to have her own private bathroom, so I actually had them split the bathroom in half into two separate full bathrooms. So I went for a sparkly white countertop for Zaya's bathroom with the same gray cabinetry that you guys have already seen throughout the house. And then through here is her bedroom. So she has plenty of space to get her big girl bed. She's gonna be getting her like full-size bed in here. Nightstands on either side. She's got big windows. You can put some cute curtains. I really wanna paint like a mural in here somewhere because she has tons of like wall space. Definitely stay tuned for future videos as I take you guys through the process of decorating. I also have a Nest indoor security camera in here. So again, just like in the playroom, I can watch her from my phone. And then she has her nice walk-in closet. I went ahead and did a custom closet system for her as well. This is from the Container Store. It's called the Elfa Decor System. Everything is changeable and rearrangeable so that as she grows, as her stuff changes, I can kind of rearrange the shelving in here to fit her needs. So this is the guest room. Like I said, that room downstairs that I'm using for my glam room could also be the guest room, but I decided to use this room as the guest room instead. It's a nice size bedroom. I really like this cute little window over here that has like the little balcony touch to it. There's another window over here, so it brings in lots of natural light. And of course, I'm gonna have, you know, queen size bed, all the furniture in here, dresser, TV, everything set up all nicely for my guests. And through here, they have their full bathroom. So like I said, I decided to split the bathroom in half so that the guests can have a full private bathroom and Zaya can have her own private bathroom. So in Zaya's bathroom, she has the shower tub combo just because she's still little, so she still uses a bathtub. But in the guest room, I just did the stand-up shower with the glass doors. They have their own toilet and their own sink. It's the same countertop and cabinets that match Zaya's, but it just kind of gives them that privacy. And then through here is actually a walk-in closet for the guest room as well, which also kind of doubles as my media internet hub. So all the internet speaker systems hookup stuff is in there as well. So it's nicely tucked away where pretty much nobody is gonna see it. So yeah, guys, that is my entire new home. I can't believe that I'm even making this video right now, you guys. I'm still in shock that this is my house. This is literally my dream home. I am in love with it. I just think it's coming together so nicely. It's everything I dreamed of, and I would have never thought that I would own this home at this age, at this stage of my life, but it's mine and I'm super excited and I'm super thankful and grateful and just, I can't wait to, you know, finish decorating. I know I have a long way to go with all the actual furniture and decor and everything like that, and it is gonna take a while, but I just wanted to go ahead and show you guys what the house itself is looking like right now. And I really hope that you guys like it too. If you do, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on all of my home decor, shopping, decorating. You know, I'm gonna be doing so much content about this house. You guys are gonna see the entire process of decorating and fleshing out all the rooms. So make sure that you are subscribed so you don't miss out on any of that stuff. But yeah, that's everything. So I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.